solved in the next 4 to 6 weeks if the drivers need training and being recruited. So no, I don't see any end date to this for the foreseeable future, because I know what the problem is. It's a lack of drivers.
Amy, as you're speaking, I can see that Bruce Williamson from Railfuture is nodding away. Bruce, just explain a little bit more on that for us.
Well, it is a staffing issue. It's a sort of lack of planning issue. Obviously, when you have a whole complex new timetable with new services, improved services, you need the staff to back that up. You need the drivers trained and ready, and they simply aren't there. They just haven't had enough. And, you know, I think we need to blame both the train operating companies and the Department for Transport here. I mean, Chris Grayling is trying to pass the buck onto the industry, but the Department for Transport, you know, are responsible in many ways for sort of micromanaging the train operating companies. And when they sort of accept these franchise bids, they tend to go for the lowest bid, which means the bid with the lowest amount of staffing, because that's the lowest amount of expenditure. And then we find ourselves in a position where the staff just aren't in place to run the new services when they're due to start.
People at home watching this will say, how on earth can there not be communication between all of the different people involved here to make sure that this doesn't happen?
I think there's no excuse, really. I think all the parties are to blame. The Department for Transport are guilty in the way I've just mentioned. The train operating companies have failed to put the staff in place and to train them. And Network Rail have failed to deliver. I mean, it's like watching a car crash in slow motion. And I think it is inexcusable, because there isn't anything that's cropped up at the very last minute to throw a spanner in the works. All of this has sort of been anticipated for years, possibly even decades, and it should have been better planned for.
Amy, how is this affecting your work? Because presumably you're turning up late most days.
Well, I'm actually getting 2 trains earlier than I would have to, which is why I'm having to get up so early in the morning. Because for places like Birmingham, you just can't drive. I'm in Coventry on Monday morning and I have to get the train. But rather than get the train that gets me in an hour early, I think, well, that may be cancelled. So I have to get 2 hours early, which then means I'm getting less sleep. And it's really disrupting my life and taking so much time out of my day every day.
So what would make you happy? Clearly sorting out these services, but do you want compensation as well?
I do, and I am regularly claiming the compensation, but ironically even the website itself says there's a delay in repaying the compensation.
Somewhat ironic there, yeah. Then, isn't it, Bruce? I mean, and presumably the compensation isn't a huge amount when you think that, you know, Amy's having to get up 2 hours earlier.
No, I mean, I suppose the compensation is fair enough in a way, and it's a slight recompense for the inconvenience that the passengers are suffering, but clearly it's not good enough. And unfortunately, there isn't a quick fix here. There's no magic bullet, and I'm afraid, whilst I'm not going to put a timescale on it, there isn't going to be a quick fix to all this, sadly.
That's not what you want to hear, is it, Amy?
No.
No.
Is it just you that's affected in your office, or do you find that lots of your colleagues are also having to battle through this?
I think everybody's being affected, and I'm grateful to this programme for doing something about it, because I was sat on a train with somebody the other day that had missed their holiday as a result of their train being cancelled and then the subsequent train being delayed, and then the train that she was on decided it wasn't going to stop at Manchester Airport because of significant delays and other problems. So everybody is being affected by this. I'm aware of it, so I'm able to plan ahead, and it is just disrupting me, but some people have no idea and then turn up to the train station and then miss their holiday, for example.
Are people angry at the train station, or are people kind of just going with it?
No, they're angry, and I feel sorry for the members of staff that are having to take the abuse, because people are angry and they are venting on the members of staff.
Well, listen, thank you ever so much for speaking to us this morning, and best of luck. I hope that your journey into and out of work does improve. Thank you also, Bruce, for speaking to us this morning. Now, still to come, we will get an update on Edith Monk's story. She lives with MS, and at just 30 years old, faces having to move into a care home. Now, it's a grief no expectation.